So what I decided to do was pick a video that sort of encompasses a majority of the techniques that I've learned up until now. And the one that I picked was a video of me making B-roll of my sister-in-law making a cup of tea. And I deliberately picked a mundane thing like making a cup of tea because I wanted to see how fun I could make it look or how interesting I could make it look. And so what I'm gonna try to demonstrate is the steps that it took me to get to this video. And again, the point of this, hopefully if I do this right, is not necessarily a tutorial, although you may pick up something from it, but it's more to demonstrate to you the few tools that I picked up and how I was able to use them to make something that I had in my mind. Hopefully that'll give you some motivation to dive in if this is something that intimidates you and makes you hesitate, or maybe gives you some motivation to look into whatever it is that you might want to try and hopefully be less intimidated. Okay, so opening up Premiere Pro, you start a new project, super simple. And so now we have our project and we have our project window. Just a quick overview as to what's going on here. This window right here is called the program window. That is going to display your project as you work on it. The timeline here is your actual workspace. That's where you kind of make your storyboard and all that stuff. Things are gonna be moved onto there. Your source is basically where you can preview the stuff in your project section. So your project section can be displayed in the source window, and then your timeline section will be displayed in the program window. What I wanna do, like I said, is sort of break down a little bit the process, and I'm going to try and remake that video while showing you how I did it. And so I kind of want to break it down into four major groupings. The first is going to be basic stuff, moving your footage over into Premiere Pro, trimming the video and adding some transitions. The second thing is going to be the really juicy stuff, which is the speed ramping. That's going to be the part that makes the video kind of slow down and speed up and make it look a little bit more dramatic. The next part is going to be adding audio, whether it's sound effects, music, they all pretty much function the same way. And the last part of it is something really interesting called adjustment layers. Now, I don't fully completely understand everything about adjustment layers, but what I've been using it for is to actually add on other effects like color adjustments and adding the cinematic bars and things like that. Really cool stuff. So today we're gonna talk about just the simple stuff of trimming and adding some transitions. What you wanna do inside Premiere Pro, but also outside on your desktop, is organize your files and your folders. I'm in my folder that has all of the footage that I made, and I've already looked through these clips, and I already know which clips that I want to use as my final project. This way, what I can do is when I go into Premiere Pro, I can just take that file and drag it directly into my project space. So by dragging it directly over, the folder is already labeled, and all of the clips that I want to use are all ready to go here. So the next step that I need to do is I need to actually make what's called a sequence. The sequence is basically the foundation on which you're gonna put your video clips. And the major thing about the sequence is the settings that you wanna make it. Now, I like making a cinematic look, so I'm going to make the frame rate look cinematic, which is usually 24 frames a second. What that'll actually do is it'll make all of your clips fit on a 24 frame sequence. And then the resolution I'm gonna use is gonna be 1080p. I'm gonna click on new item, open up sequence. So when I open up the sequence window, I go over to settings and I make sure that the frame rate is on a 24 frame per second time base. And I make sure that the resolution is 1920 by 1080, display format also on a 24 frames a second. The audio I leave alone, that's all standard. And I just click okay. And now you see a sequence popped up here. Now from this point, it's as simple as taking your clips and dragging them over onto your timeline. So we're gonna start with the kettle steam. Is this a clip that I want? Yes, it is getting the teacup out. So that's the next one that I want in the sequence. I wanna take the teabag grab, put it over here, putting the teabag in the cup, or in this case, tossing the teabag into the cup. Teabag drop goes next. Pouring the water. After pouring the water, we're gonna pour some milk and finally serve the cup. So now we've got all the clips that we want to use onto the timeline, that all of the clips, at least in the raw, unedited, are all there. They're in the order that we want. And so from this point, I have a basic blueprint with which I can shrink clips, expand clips, slow them down, speed them up, and add them together the way I want. So now at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at each individual clip and cut out the parts that I don't want. And so, for example, here we notice that in the beginning, there is a bunch of dead space, and that's when it starts to move. Among these tools, there's a little razor blade here, and I want it to cut there. And now that's just separated the clips into two separate clips. It literally just cuts it. That's literally the technique that people use for every single video that they have when they want to remove stuff. You make a big video, you put cuts in it, and then you just bring them back together, and then you have your shortened clip. Now, when you watch other videos on YouTube or wherever, and you see them jump cutting through their monologue, that's what they're doing. Super simple. So those are some examples of how I would take a couple of clips that I've made, cut them up the way I need to, and then kind of just stick them together. If you take little steps, you start to realize the simple tools that are there. You learn those tools, and you just apply them, and you make a simple video. So the next thing that we're gonna check out on the next video is we're going to play with a little bit of speed ramping and then combine the transitions to make things start to look a little bit more smooth. So until then, I hope that this was somewhat useful. I hope that this is starting to maybe give you a little bit of motivation to get out there and try something you haven't tried yet. Again, this is stuff that I had no idea how to do. This is all stuff that I just recently learned. And these last few videos that you see on my channel are all a result of me learning these little techniques. In the next episode, we're gonna check out the speed ramping, and I will see you there.